Hello, everyone. Meteorologist Mike Haddad here in the Storm Watch 9 Weather Center, keeping close eye on Hurricane Lee in the tropics. We've been doing that all week long, leading us into our weekend. The storm is still well off to our south, down north of the Caribbean right now. As of the 5 o'clock advisory Saturday early evening, it had top sustained winds of 115 miles per hour. That makes it a Category 3 hurricane. Keep in mind, Lee was a monster Category 5 a couple of days ago, weakened considerably, but is expected to intensify as we go through the night and into the day on Sunday. So the present pressure, 958 millibars, it's actually dropped a little bit in the last few hours. So the winds are likely to pick up between now and later on tonight, early on Sunday morning, moving to the west-northwest at about 10 miles per hour. Now it is beginning to slow down a little bit, and that will actually lead into some tricky projections beyond the middle part of next week. So the track for now is well north of the Leeward Islands, well north of Puerto Rico and Hispaniola, and even far enough to the east of the Bahamas. So really, outside of rough surf, no major threats from Hurricane Lee down to our south. But notice, starting Wednesday into Thursday, the storm begins to turn to the northwest and eventually the north. Where does it go beyond then? Well, steering currents in the atmosphere are going to drive it to the north, but is it north and arcing back northwest towards New England or up through Nova Scotia or Newfoundland? A lot of our computer guidance, as you can see here by all of these lines indicating each computer model's projection, most of it is to our east. However, as we look at a few more spaghetti lines, these are what we call our computer models, and a lot of people like to call it spaghetti chart because it kind of looks that way a little bit, I guess. I mean, that's what we're going to call it. That's it. But notice a couple of those computer models drive it right through now New England, many others off to our east. Basically, what this means is it's too close for comfort. And speaking of which, this is the setup for the end of next week. An area of high pressure, we call it a Bermuda High, it sits there all summer, is sitting to the east of Hurricane Lee. Now, to the west of that, approaching the east coast of the United States, is a trough of low pressure. Now, initially, the one that moves in Wednesday and Thursday will try to capture Lee, driving it to the north. However, if it doesn't kick it out to sea, another one that fills in Friday into Saturday could kick that storm back closer to New England. The bottom line, still big questions 7 days out as to where Hurricane Lee will be a week from now, Saturday night into early Sunday morning. So stay tuned. We'll have important updates through the rest of the weekend.